does it with such a lilt in his voice. Mishel Prada is here, and this is really interesting. These Vida billboards are absolutely everywhere.
They are.
It is the touristy thing, and I've done it myself. Have you driven and taken a picture of yourself near the billboard in proximity?
I actually have taken a photo of myself in front of the mural. They painted a mural. They had a Mexican artist paint one on Melrose and Fairfax. Unfortunately, I've had to go 5 times because every single time a friend or family member wants to do it, they want to go see the mural and take the photos. So the people that stand by the mural are probably like, why is she back? It's really weird.
But this excitement and promotion, the show premieres this weekend, all based in Los Angeles, shot in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
What is Vida about?
Vida takes place in the side of LA, but like the proper east side, not Silver Lake, not
not the corrupted east side.
No, not the east side, like the east
right.
side. And it's two Mexican-American sisters that are estranged from their neighborhood they grew up in and have to come back and face their past.
And this phrase, and I'm going to say it wrong, Latina X, say it for me.
Yeah, you can say Latinx or Latinx.
Okay.
Depending on if you want to.
And what does it reference?
So it's a gender-inclusive term. So Spanish is very gendered. It's Latina, Latino.
Sure.
And especially in our cast, we have non-binary, gender-conforming actors. And it's a more inclusive term. So when you're discussing a group of people, you're not calling them all by the male gendered term.
A lot of people say this binary stuff is... I don't know, this is the wrong word, but that it's difficult for some people to accept. Oh, gee, why are they doing that? And some people have suggested, because often Latin families are very steeped in tradition.
Oh, yeah.
It's particularly difficult.
It can be a little difficult, but I think if you can do something that can make somebody feel included, make somebody feel seen, then why not? You're not giving them money, you're not like, you know, bring them into your house or anything. It's just something that you can say that makes people feel included. I don't see anything wrong with it.
Speaking of inclusion, they just had a new report about sort of diversity and how it is reflected on the screen, both television and the Latino population, though making strides, it's shocking the degree of underrepresentation. You know, there are so many Latinos in our community and in the overall population, and you don't see that on television.
Yeah, and I think that that's a huge beauty that we're getting to explore within the show. And it's not only with brown people, but it's queer, specifically brown, queer, and then women. So we have like three versions of things that are underrepresented that we get to explore in our show.
All right, some representation here. Here's a clip from Vida. Watch this.
Did you know?
What, that she was sick? No. No, I didn't. I was as surprised as you were, I swear to God.
You apparently knew that she had a random roommate.
Well, that's because I actually talked to Mommy. Talked to Mommy.
Please, you calling me that anytime you're short on rent isn't exactly talking, is it?
What's wrong with you? Our mother is dead. I know you and Mommy had your whatever, your, like, disagreements.
Disagreements?
Can we just, Emma?
Really?
Emma, she's dead!
Boy, that's when stuff like that plays real, and it plays so real like that. And they say cut.
Yeah.
Where does your head go?
You just keep going. You keep the ideas between the scenes, and then just go right back into it.
One of the plot lines here, you know, that we talked about Echo Park and other places, all this gentrification.
Yeah.
And that's coming everywhere. And do you think that comes at a cost to some degree?
Absolutely. And I think also what we explore is gentrification. It's the younger generation coming back. And can they gentrify their own neighborhood, even though they're from that neighborhood? Can they still have the awareness to care for what's already there and not push their people out?
I have never heard that phrase before. That's so interesting. Is that a real thing?
Oh, yeah. It's a real thing. I learned it actually once I booked the show. And I was like, oh, am I a gentrifier? Oh, man. It might be,
Vida premieres this Sunday at 8:30 p.m. on Starz. If you don't believe me, check out a huge billboard on Sunset. I see it every morning.
And the mural.
And the mural. That, too. So nice to see you this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So much.